guys, this weekend we are here in Byron Bay, so we are having yoga class here, and this time we couldn't get any sponsor for the class, but we are still looking for sponsors for our project. So if you want to support our project, please share this video with your friends, tell everybody what you're doing, and if you have a company and you want to support the project, please get in touch. Our website is namaste108.com. Let's start it. All right. It's a bit noisy here. Can you hear me well? All right. So this class is part of a project my husband and I are doing. So we are traveling around Australia with our camper van and stopping each city to teach yoga for free. So this is our project called Namaste 108. And yeah, that's it. We are traveling and teaching yoga for free in the park. To start it, you can choose your legs position. You can just cross your legs. Or if you prefer, you can also sit on your feet, on your heels, so it's up to you. The most important thing now is to keep your back very straight and your shoulders relaxed. Place your hands on your knees or on your lap, it's up to you. And close your eyes for a moment. Start taking some deep breaths. And start to calm your body down and quiet your mind. This is your moment to connect with yourself. So feel your breathing and feel your heartbeat. And then you bring your attention to the sounds of nature. So listen to the ocean. Feel the breeze touching your skin. And slowly you bring your hands together in front of your chest. And here you set your intention for this class today. So think about what do you want with this class today. Maybe you want to feel more relaxed, or maybe you want to send energy to someone in your life, or send energy to some situation in the world. So this moment is for you to set your intention. Take a deep breath. And open your eyes. Before we start the positions, I'll spray some lavender essence on your hands. So lavender is very good to feel you relaxed. You make some heat on your hands and just feel the lavender smell. All right, so just feel the lavender smell, this will help you to feel more relaxed. And to a gently start to just slowly start to raise your arms. And here we start a gentle warm-up with the wrists. Bring your hands together, take a deep breath and grow towards the sky. When you exhale, bring the right hand to the ground and left hand to the sky. Open your chest and open your heart. And slowly come back. And twist your body to the opposite side and look back. And slowly come back. Raise your arms again, warm up your wrists. Hands together, take a deep breath. Now is the left hand to the ground, right hand to the sky. Open your chest, open your heart. And
come back and twist your body, look back. Slowly come back to the center. Place your hands a little bit behind your body. And now again, open your chest, open your heart, and relax your neck, drop your head. And slowly come back, bring your hands forward on the ground. And again, relax your shoulders, relax your neck. Relax your hands, relax your fingers. And take some deep breaths. Slowly, slowly, slowly start to come back. Extend your legs. Place your hands a little bit behind your body again. And just shake a little bit, relax your legs. Relax your feet. And then you bring your legs very, very close. Inhale and raise your body, look to the sky. Exhale and slowly come back. Bend your right knee. Bring your right foot to the other side. Inhale and raise your right arm. Open your hands, spread your fingers. Take a deep breath. And when you exhale, you twist your body again and look back. And slowly come back. Now you bring the sole of your feet touching your leg. Inhale and raise your arms, palms together. Take a deep breath. And when you exhale, you bring your hands in direction to your foot. But maybe you touch your shin or your knee, doesn't matter. It's just an intention to go forward. It's very important to remember to respect your body. So find a position you really feel comfortable. Relax your neck, relax your shoulders. And then slowly, slowly start to raise your body again. Legs together again, shake a little bit. And now you are going to the other side. So you bend your left knee. Left foot going to the other side of your leg. And let's get ready to twist. So first, hands towards the sky. Take a deep breath. And just when you exhale, you twist your body. With the right hand, you can just hold your leg. And slowly release. Now you bring the sole of your feet touching your leg. Inhale and raise your arms, hands together. Take a deep breath. Exhale, bring your hands towards your foot. Relax your neck, relax your shoulders. And then slowly, slowly come back your back to the center. Now you're going to the hands and the knees. So open your hands as much as you can. Spread your fingers. And make sure you have the perfect alignment with your wrist, your elbow, and your shoulder. So your hands are not too close and not too far. And the same with your knees. You have the perfect line with your thighs and your hips. Here we are going to the cat and cow breathing for a gentle start of our back. So it's the movement together with the breathing. Every time you inhale, you raise your chin, look to the sky. And when you exhale, chin to the chest. Inhale and raise your chin. Exhale, chin to the chest. So close your eyes and keep doing on your own pace. Try to do as much slowly as you can. Really feeling the movements. Slowly bring your spine to a neutral pose. And then you keep the left hand on the ground and raise your right arm and your left leg. So keep your toes pointing to the ground, so then you're feeling the stretching on the leg. And keep looking to the ground, so then you don't have any tension on your neck. And then slowly try to grab your foot. Arch your spine a little bit. Raise your chin. And release. Bring your hips to the heels and relax in child pose. Take some deep breaths. Relax your neck, relax your shoulders. And slowly, slowly, slowly go back to your hands and your knees. So cute. Now we are going to the other side. So right hand stays on the ground. Raise your left arm and the right leg. Remember to keep your toes pointing to the ground so then you're feeling the stretching on your leg. And keep looking to the ground to don't have any tension on your neck, any tension on your shoulders. And slowly release. Go back to the child pose. Take some deep breaths. Relax your neck, relax your arms. So the child pose, it's your safe pose during the yoga class. Anytime you feel you need some rest, you need to take a break during the class, you can stop everything you're doing and go to the child pose. Take some deep breaths and then keep going with the class. So remember, you can always go to the child pose. Take one more deep breath. And when you exhale, slowly, slowly start to come back until you sit on your heels. Now you bring your hands in namaste behind your body, like this. Or you can also hold your shoulders. So you have these two options. Here you're starting to open the shoulders, open the chest. And then slowly raise your left arm. And then you try to bring your hands together. If you can't have your fingers together, you can just hold your shirt. So this position is the half cow face pose. And it's related to love and compassion because we are opening the chest and working with our heart center. So in this moment, you can imagine the color green in the middle of your chest. So imagine a green light. This is the color of this energy. And you can close your eyes for a few minutes just to connect with this point of energy. Take a deep breath and release. Relax your shoulders. On the opposite way. And let's get ready to the other side. So again, bring your hands in namaste behind your back. And then you raise your right arm. And gently bring your fingers together. Now connect with that energy again in the middle of your chest. But think about someone that you love. And send this energy of love to this person. Take a deep breath and release. Relax your shoulders again. On the opposite way. And then go to your knees. Extend the right leg. And here you bring the right hand to your leg. The left hand goes to the sky. So here you're doing a gentle stretch on the side of your body. Slowly come back and turn to the left side. Here you're going to the pigeon pose. So you have some options. You can sit beside your legs to feel more comfortable. You can keep extending your leg if you like. Or if you feel comfortable, you can hold your foot. And if you're still feeling comfortable, you can just place your foot on your arm. So try these three options and choose which one is better for you. Maybe you're feeling pain on this one, you need to come back a little bit. So it's up to you. The important thing here is to open the chest, open the heart. If you're holding your foot, you can bring your leg back to the ground. And now you just relax your forehead on your hands. Take some deep breaths. And slowly, slowly raise your body again. Knees together again. And let's go to the other side. So extend your left leg. Raise your right arm. and feel the gentle stretching on the side of your body. Slowly come back. And we are going to the pigeon pose to the other side. So first take a moment to feel comfortable with your legs. And just when you feel ready, you can choose your pose, holding your foot or placing your foot on your arm. So it's up to you. Open your chest, open your heart. So in these positions, we are working with hip opener. And this is very good to work with our emotions. So sometimes if you stay for a long time in this position, sometimes people start to cry because you deal with all these emotions and all these emotions come in form of crying. So it's very good to work with hip openers. If you're holding your foot, now you can release the leg. And again, just relax your head on your hands. Take some deep breaths. Relax your shoulders, relax your neck. Slowly, slowly start to raise your body again. From here, we are going to the downward facing dog. So you lift your hips and start a gentle stretching with your legs so you can bend your knees one by one. Take your dog for a walk, a very gentle stretching. Stop the movement and raise your right leg. Bend your right knee and bring your right foot between your hands. Knee to the ground and raise your arms. Then you bring your left hand to the ground. Raise your leg, and the other hand goes to the sky. Slowly bring the right hand back to the ground and go back to the downward facing dog. Take some deep breaths. And let's get ready to the other side. So raise your left leg. Bend your left knee. And bring your left foot between your hands. Knee to the ground, hands towards the sky. Open your hands and spread your fingers. So feel the energy going through your arm, through your hand, and going to your fingertips. And now you bring the right hand to the ground, lift your leg, and left hand goes to the sky. Bring your hand back to the ground, and now bring your feet together with your hands. You can bend your knees and hug your legs. Relax your neck, relax your shoulders, and feel this connection with your body. So it's so good to hug yourself. Feel this love for your legs. Feel love for your body. then relax your arms, let it go. And slowly, 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 as much as slowly as you can, start to raise your body. Bring your hands together. And just when you exhale, bring your hands in front of your chest. Just mark a couple of times. So it's the movement together with the breathing. Inhale, the hands go up and together. And just when you exhale, hands to the heart center. One more time, inhale. And exhale. Keep your hands in front of your chest with your eyes still closed. And bring your attention to your feet. So connect with your feet. Feel the sole of your feet in contact with the ground. And imagine you have roots on your feet going under the ground. So this is your connection with the planet, your connection with nature. Take a moment to really feel this connection. Take a deep breath. And open your eyes. So from here you're going to the sun salutation. The sun salutation is a very traditional sequence in yoga, and it's very it's a very nice sequence you can do when you don't have time to practice yoga, because it's a complete yoga sequence in just a small period of time, let's say like this. And it's very good to practice it to bring lots of energy to the body. So to start, come to the beginning of your tao. And left a space behind you. Inhale and raise your arms, hands together, look to the sky. Exhale and bend forward. Here you can bend your knees if you feel more comfortable to bring your fingertips to the ground. Relax your neck, relax your shoulders. And next time you inhale, raise your body just halfway, lengthening the spine and look up. Exhale and fold forward again. And bring your feet back to the plank pose. Here you have two options. You can bring your body very slowly to the ground in Chaturanga. Or you can bend your knees and bring your chest. So you have these two options. And from here we are going to the cobra pose. So open your chest, relax your shoulders. And when you next time you exhale, you are going to the downward facing dog. So lift your hips and take some deep breaths. Next time you inhale, look to your hands and big step. Bring your feet between your hands. Raise your body halfway, lengthening the spine and look up. Exhale and bend forward again. Inhale and raise your body, raise your arms, hands together. Exhale, bring your hands in front of your chest and close your eyes a little bit. Take some deep breaths and start to feel the energy in your heart. Take one more deep breath and open your eyes. So we are doing this second smart two times. Make sure you have that space. I'll do on this side now. Make sure you have a space behind you. And when if you're ready, you can start. So inhale and raise your arms. Curve your spine just a little bit. Look to the sky. Exhale and bend forward. Inhale and look up, lengthening the spine. Exhale and fold forward again. And bring your feet back to the plank pose. Knees to the ground, chest to the ground, or chaturanga is up to you. And then open your chest to cobra. Exhale and downward facing dog. Lift your hips and take some deep breaths. Next time you inhale, bring your feet between your hands. Raise your body halfway, lengthening the spine and look up. Exhale and fold forward again. Inhale and raise your body, raise your arms, look to the sky. Exhale, hands in front of your chest. Close your eyes for a moment. Take some deep breaths. Take one more deep breath and open your eyes. Let's do it just one more time. Inhale and raise your arms, hands together, look to the sky. Exhale and fold forward. Remember, you can always bend your knees if you feel more comfortable. Inhale and raise your body just halfway, lengthening the spine and look up. Exhale and bend forward again. And go to the plank pose. From here, you can go to chaturanga or just bring your knees in chest. And open your chest to cobra. And the next time you exhale, downward facing dog. Take some deep breaths. And then bring your feet between your hands. Raise your body halfway and look up. Exhale and fold forward. Inhale and raise your body, raise your arms, look to the sky. Exhale, hands in front of your chest. So keep your eyes closed just a little bit more and connect with the energy you're feeling in your heart. Take one more deep breath and open your eyes. Make a little space between your legs. And here you're going to twist side to side just to relax your back. So relax your shoulders, relax your neck, relax your hands and your fingers. And stop slowly, slowly. Feet together again. And we are going to our balance pose. So bring your left hand, left arm in front of you, making a 90 degrees with your elbow. This is quite difficult to explain, but try to see how to do it. So bring your right hand under your arm and behind. Here you kind of twist your arms and your hands to bring your palms together. If you can't touch your palms together, you can just bring to your arm. Yeah, that's it. Raise your arms a little bit. And now you're doing the same with the legs. So if your right knee, you bend a little bit. And imagine you want to cross your legs and sit. So you bring your left leg up, behind. And imagine you want to hide your foot behind your leg. Keep breathing very slowly. And then release the legs. And release your arms. Relax your shoulders. And let's go to the other side. So, right hand in front of you. Left arm comes down and twist, palms together. Raise a little bit, and now you're going to the leg. So bend your left knee, right leg up, and twist. Keep breathing very slowly. Try to keep the back straight at the same time. I know it's lots of things to do at the same time. So take your time. And then release the legs. And release your arms. Relax your shoulders. Shake a little bit. And now bring your hands in Kali Mudra. So interlace all your fingers, just the index together. Take a deep breath. And when you exhale, start to bend your knees slowly, slowly, slowly. Until you sit on your heels. Keep the back very straight. And bring your hands to your knees. So this is another balance pose. If you want to challenge yourself, you can try to close your eyes. If you feel you lose your balance, you can just open again. And try to close just for a few seconds and open again. I know it's not easy, but it's a very good exercise, a balance exercise. If you close your eyes, now you can open your eyes again. And without using your hands, you sit on the ground. Sole of your feet together. Entrelace your fingers to hold your feet. And this is Baddha Konasana, the butterfly pose. So just do slow movements with your legs. Try to keep the back very straight. And then you stop the movement with the legs. And now you can curve your spine and relax your neck. So let it go, any tension you have on the neck, any tension you have on the shoulders. And slowly come back. With the help of your hands, you bring your legs together again and hold your legs behind your knees. I will show you first and then we do it together. We are going to an inversion on the shoulders. So first you make sure you have a space behind you. And before going to the inversion, we are going to Lolasana. So Lolasana is the name of this movement. We are going three times. After three times, you just go and hold your back. When you come back from this pose, we have to compensate. So you sit on your hands and bring the top of your head to the ground. So let's do it together. Three times in Lolasana, one, two, three. Next time you go and hold your back. Feeling comfortable? Okay. Feeling comfortable the pose? Or feeling some pain on the back?
A little bit, but it's...
Yeah, you can try to change the movement on the legs. You can keep the feet pointing to the sky, or you can bring closer, so then you find your position, you find where is more comfortable for you. Let's get ready to come back. So slowly, slowly bring your body back to the ground as much slowly as you can. And then you extend your legs. And let's compensate. So bring your hands behind your body. And then you bring the top of your hands to the ground. So I'll help you. Actually, one by one, I think it'll be easier. Yeah, you was right. Can you bring the top? Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's it. Slowly release. Bend your knees. And just hug your legs behind your knees. And do slow movements side to side. Relax your back. Relax your neck. Really enjoy this massage on your back. Now, before we go to relaxation, this is your moment to do whatever you want to do, as long as you stay on the ground. So listen to your body and see what your body is asking for you to do. Maybe you want to keep holding your legs, or maybe you want to do any other movement. Maybe you want to twist to one side, to the other side. Just listen to your body and do whatever you want to do now. Thank you. And now let's get ready to our relaxation pose. So you have two options of pose to relaxation. You can keep bending your knees together, feet apart, and hands on your belly. Or you can just extend your legs and open your arms. During the relaxation, I want to offer you a massage on your head. So if for some reason you don't want this massage, you can just keep the hands on the belly. Or if you want the massage, just keep the hands on the ground. It's up to you.
Let's go!
So start taking some deep breaths. And this is your moment to relax your body. So you don't need to worry about anything. You don't need to think about anything. All you have to do is allow your body to relax. So during this relaxation, I want you to bring your attention to the sound of the waves. So listen to the ocean. And every time you start to think about something, bring your attention back to the ocean. slowly with your eyes still closed. Start taking deeper and deeper breaths. Start to bring your awareness back to your body. And very slowly start to wake up your body, doing slow movements with your fingers, your toes. Slow movements with your hands, your feet. And slowly start to spread these movements to your arms and your legs. You can have a stretch if you like. So just find a way to gently wake up your body. Remember to keep your eyes still closed, just for a few seconds more. And when you feel ready, choose one side to lay down. And with your eyes still closed and with the help of your hands, slowly you push yourself up to a comfortable seated position. Remember to keep the back very straight and the shoulders relaxed. And bring the palms of your hands together in front of your chest. For a moment, just try to notice how your body's feeling now. Feel your breathing and feel your heartbeat. To finish our class, I will chant the mantra Om. So if you want, you can do it with me, or you can do it just in your mind, or you can just keep listening to the mantra. Take a deep breath. Loka Samastha Sukhino Bhavantu. May all beings be happy and free. From my heart to your heart, Namaste.